Jesus, Jesus. Oh, what a wonderful time. Jesus, Jesus, the holy, meek and mild. New life, new hope, new joy it brings. Listen to the angels sing. Glory, glory, glory to the newborn kingdom calling you, Jesus, Jesus. Oh, what a wonderful child, Jesus, Jesus, the holy, meek and mild, yeah, new life, new hope, new joy it brings. Listen to the angels sing, glory, glory, glory to the newborn King. Oh, he will tell, oh, by the angel, and born in the lonely maze, the Virgin Mary was his mother, and Joseph was his earthly father. Three wise men traveled from afar, and they were guided by the shining star to see the baby. Jesus, where he lay in a manger, filled with haste, we're calling on Jesus, yeah, Jesus, and we say, oh, what a wonderful child, yeah, Jesus, oh, Jesus, he's so holy, meek and mild, yeah, new life, new hope, to all he brings. Listen to the angels sing. Glory, glory, glory to the newborn King. He is found by the angels, born in the holy manger. The Virgin Mary was his mother. Jesus, oh, what a wonderful child, oh, Jesus, Jesus, the holy, meek and mild, new life, new hope, new joy it brings. Listen to the angels sing, glory, glory, glory to the newborn King. We're calling on Jesus, Emmanuel, Emmanuel, Prince of Peace, Jesus, Prince of Peace. Heavenly Father, Jesus, Heavenly Father, Jesus, born in a manger, Jesus, one Christmas morning, Jesus, one Christmas morning, no room in the inn, Jesus, 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 Jesus. There is power, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Jesus. There is joy, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Jesus. There is Jesus, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, Jesus. He was born from a manger, called Jesus. His name is Jesus. I tell you to trust Jesus. I tell you to trust Jesus. I tell you to trust Jesus. Everything you need, Jesus. Everything you need, Jesus, is in Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Jesus.
Now after they had left, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother and flee to Egypt, and remain there until I tell you, for Herod is about to search for the child to destroy him." Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother by night and went to Egypt, and remained there until the death of Herod. This was to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet, "Out of Egypt I have called my son." When Herod saw that he had been tricked by the wise men, he was infuriated, and he sent and killed all the children in and around Bethlehem who were 2 years old or under, according to the time that he had learned from the wise men. Then was fulfilled what had been spoken through the prophet Jeremiah, "A voice heard in Ramah, wailing and loud lamentations, Rachel weeping for her children. She refused to be consoled because they are no more." When Herod died, an angel of the Lord suddenly appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, "Get up, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who were seeking the child's life are dead." Then Joseph got up, took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus was ruling over Judea in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. And after warned in a dream, he went away to the district of Galilee. There he made his home in a town called Nazareth. So that was what had been spoken through the prophets might be fulfilled. He will be called a Nazarene. The word of God for us, the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Most gracious God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. For God, you are our rock, our strength, and our redeemer. Amen. Well, Merry Christmas, everyone. I'm the Pastor Mike Williams, and I want to thank you so much for joining us for worship today. We know that you could have joined any other virtual service, but you've decided to tune in to We Are One virtual service, and for that, we are truly grateful. Over the past several weeks, we've been in celebration of Advent. It's a season of preparation, preparing for the Christ to come, and also celebrating the Christ who came. It's a season of hope, of joy, of love, and of peace. And on Christmas morning, hope, love, joy, and peace was realized by the birth of Jesus the Christ. And it's in this season that we have now began the Christmas season, the 12 days of Christmas. It's also in this season that I often reflect on the birth of my own child. On December the 15th, 2015, my daughter Ava Grace was born. And I can remember during that year when my wife Katina announced her pregnancy, the roller coaster of emotions that I felt and the questions that I had for God and for myself. As a traveling salesperson, would my traveling time change? Would Kat and I and our relationship that we had, would it change as a new baby coming into our world along with our Hannah? Would life itself change? Would my time change? Would my hangout time change? Would it change? And one thing I didn't know was what the future held. But the one thing I did know is that babies change everything. What a difference a newborn child brings. For when we welcome a baby into our homes and into our lives, everything changes. Our priorities change. Our schedules and our routines change. Our identities change. Our relationships change. Even our environment change. We have to baby-proof the environment to make sure that the environment is safe for our little one. A baby changes everything. And if a baby changes everything, how much more does Jesus' birth changes everything? That Jesus' birth is a game changer. The wise men knew that Jesus' birth changed everything. They journeyed from afar, not because they were stargazing or just because they were curious or just because they had adventurous spirits or just because they had time off work and the means to travel. No, they journeyed from afar because they knew that a baby changes everything. They knew that a king was born. So they welcomed his birth. They desired to pay homage and longed to worship, to honor him. So they went to King Herod to find out where this Jesus was born. Where's the child, they asked, the one who had been born of the Jews? And when Herod heard this, he was afraid. He was frightened, and others in Jerusalem was afraid as well. And King Herod called the scholars, he called the scribes and the priests to see where Jesus, the Messiah, the anointed one, would be born. And they told him, Bethlehem. From out of Bethlehem, a ruler would be born. He would be the shepherd of the people of Israel, providing leadership and guidance and protection and safety. The government will be upon his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. of the greatness of his government and peace, there would be no end. He would reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time and forever. Queen Harriet did not receive this news of Jesus' birth with wonder and awe and excitement and great joy. No, this itty bitty teeny little baby caused him great threat. Jesus threatened his empire and his throne, his leadership and his power and his influence. Queen Harriet feared rebellion and revolution. He feared a new king and a new kingdom. He feared a new reality and a new script and a new song. He didn't know what the future held, but the one thing he did know for sure, this baby changes everything. So he tells the wise men to return and to share the exact location of Jesus so that he too could worship. And when the wise men did not return, the king goes from frightened to being furious. He had been tricked. He had been played a fool. So he does the unthinkable. He issues a national security directive that all the children around Bethlehem who were 2 years of age and younger would be killed. And despite the horror of that was inflicted upon others, Jesus remained safe because Joseph had a dream. An angel instructed him and his family to flee to Egypt and remain there until further notice. Only when they knew that King Herod had died did Jesus and his parents return to the land of Israel. They relocated to the district of Galilee and they made home in a town called Nazareth. We are one, and our other friends, Jesus' birth was a game changer. Nothing was ever the same, for don't you know that a baby changes everything? For this baby, the king proclaimed a new reality, a new kingdom. He flipped the script and he sang a new song. Unlike King Herod, he didn't rule by force or military might or by manipulation. He didn't seek to destroy or to conquer people he considered as enemy or a threat. He didn't value violence or greed or division. No, this baby, this king, this Messiah, the anointed one, he was divinely appointed to bring hope and joy to people who were broken and desperate for good news. He proclaimed the message of peace and of love in the face of fear and hate. He preached about justice and righteousness in defiance of oppression and terror. He valued connection and community in the midst of division and discord. Jesus, my friends, is a game changer. And when we choose to follow him and his way, we too flip the script and we too can sing a new song. We too can change the world. Now, if I'm honest with you this morning, I didn't always want to follow Jesus closely. I remember when I felt threatened by him. When I felt threatened, my will was threatened and my way was threatened and my power and my plans were threatened. I didn't receive my ministry with awe and with wonder and with excitement and with great joy because I felt like my identity would suffer. I wanted to be my own person and do my own thing and pave my own way and do and go on my own way. I thought I knew what was best for me. So I ran from a calling. And I thought I didn't know what I wanted. But I didn't know what the future held. But I did know one thing. That Jesus changed everything. Choosing to follow him and his way would change my life. It would change my priorities. It would change my routine. Choosing to follow Jesus more closely did change everything. It would change my schedule. It would change my relationships. It would change my environment. And although it changed everything, it gave me greater purpose and peace, greater clarity and conviction. It gave me a hope in the midst of despair. And it filled my heart with an indescribable and glorious joy. Choosing to follow Jesus more closely gave me a heart for justice and a desire to engage in what Howard Thurman called the work of Christmas. In the poem by the same name, The Work of Christmas, he penned, "When the song of the angels is stilled, when the star in the sky is gone, when the kings and princes are home, when the shepherds are back with their flock, the work of Christmas begins. To find the lost, to heal the broken, to feed the hunger, to release the prisoner, to rebuild the nations, to bring peace among others, to make music in the heart." Family, when we engage in the work of Christmas, when we fight for justice in the midst of maltreatment, when we proclaim a message of hope in the face of hate and despair, when we reveal what can be instead of complaining about what always have been, when we choose to worship Jesus, when we receive his grace and follow the baby more closely, when we adhere to his guidance and his leadership, then family, we can change. We can change. We have the power and the potential to change the world. Amen. Thank you. Well, family, sadly, we've concluded another worship experience, but my prayer is that you receive a word of hope, a word of encouragement, and that you walk away with God's joy and God's peace. And is it during this season of giving and receiving gifts, the greatest gift that God ever gave us was salvation through his son, Jesus the Christ. And if you have not received the gift of salvation, we implore you to do it today. The word tells us that all we have to do is confess and believe. Confess with our mouths that Jesus Christ is Lord and that God raised him from the dead. And we should just believe it in our heart and we shall be saved. And if you are out there and you want to receive that gift, just pray that simple prayer. And if you prayed that prayer, we want to hear from you. Our information is on the screen. You can contact us via DM on our Facebook page, or you can email us. We implore you to email us or DM us because we want to walk on that journey with you. We also invite you all to come back out each and every Sunday. We have our worship experience on Facebook Live at 10 o'clock a.m. and on YouTube at 10:15 a.m. We invite you to join our Sunday school every Sunday morning virtually at 9 o'clock via Zoom. The information is on the screen. And if you stand in the need of prayer, it is our belief that the effectual fervent prayers of the righteous availeth much. And we have our midweek Wednesday prayer service is Praying Without Ceasing, led by our sister, Lisa McDonald. And we ask that you join us for this virtual experience, 7:30 Wednesday nights via Zoom. The information is on the screen. And lastly, know that I love you. Know that our senior pastor, Jerry Mannery, loves you. Know that our entire We Are One congregation loves you. But most importantly, know that God loves you. And may the God of love, peace, joy, and hope be with you. You may go in peace. Amen.